Have you ever dreamed of becoming a commercial drone pilot? To do so, you must obtain a Part 107 certification from the Federal Aviation Administration, the FAA. Hey, I'm Katia, and in this video, I'm going to discuss the Part 107 regulations regarding eligibility and the requirements you need to meet and maintain your certification. Let's start with eligibility. To become a commercial drone pilot, you must be at least 16 years old. Additionally, you must be able to read, speak, write, and understand English. You'll also need to pass the FAA's Aeronautical Knowledge Test, which covers various topics such as airspace classification, operating requirements, and weather. Once you've passed your test, you'll need to submit an application to the FAA along with a fee. If approved, you'll receive your Part 107 certification and you'll be able to fly drones commercially. That's pretty cool. However, to maintain your Part 107 certification requires more than just passing your initial test. To continue flying commercially, you must also pass the recurrent test every 24 months. You simply have to take it online at faasafety.gov. This recurrent test ensures you're up to date with any changes to the regulations and that you have a good understanding of the airspace you're flying in. As a Part 107 certified pilot, you also have to notify the FAA of any change of address within 30 days. It's important to keep the FAA informed of your address so that they can reach you if necessary. Failing to do so can result in penalties and fines. For the exam, remember these key answers. You must be 16 years old, you must pay the recurrent test every 24 months, that's every 2 years, and you have 30 days to notify the FAA of any change of address. That's 16, 24, and 30, magic numbers. Thanks for watching. I hope this video has provided you with valuable information about the Part 107 regulation regarding eligibility and certification maintenance. If you're interested in becoming a certified pilot, don't forget to subscribe to Katia's Buzz for more information, videos, and make sure you take the time to watch the full Part 107 study guide to prepare for the test. See you next time. Bye.